Keep fighting.
Service with the Soviet Navy. Alexeyev's chronoplans were fast, but they couldn't outrun the Soviet Union's economic failures. With dwindling resources, Alexeyev butted heads with Soviet leadership. And in 1975, his impatience with Soviet bureaucracy finally caught up to him. He was demoted again, this time down to the position of an ordinary employee. It was... before a final chronoplan was developed for the 1970s. Not quite as large as the KF, it carried 6 anti-ship cruise missiles and could strike targets over 100 kilometers away. But only a single example was ever built, and Alexeyev would never see it fly. In 1980, he passed away at the age of just 63, having never fully realized his vision. Funding for chronoplan development wound down by the mid-1980s. And after the Soviet Union collapsed in 1991, the few chronoplans built were quickly pulled from service, putting an end to nearly 40 years of development. But a belief in the potential of chronoplans lives on within the former Soviet Union and elsewhere in the world, with continued development focused on smaller ground effect vehicles. And that leaves an intriguing question still unanswered. With the KM, Alexeyev and his team demonstrated that the more massive an chronoplan got, the better it flew, becoming more stable, flying higher, and operating with greater efficiency. Could a machine much larger than even the KM be the key to unlocking the technology's potential? A machine that would fly 10 or 20 meters above waves could traverse oceans and potentially carry passengers and cargo far more efficiently than any aircraft. But thus far, efforts to build such a machine have failed to attract the immense resources needed for development. And that means, at least for the time being, giant chronoplan will remain a relic of the Cold War. I have a fascination with all things Soviet. Not so much this, but this. Which is why I just finished watching The Spying Game, a fantastic three-part series that...
First we fight, then we drink! Good luck!
Eliminate friendly forces in the area. Beware of rival factions. Keep your eyes on the prize. Remnant fleet reinforcements inbound.